All right. Be on the new, my heathens and assets.
Captain, as it appears we may soon be embarking for a maximum security prison planet, I believe the crew would like to speak with you to, as you humans put it, air some concerns.
Chaos Titties and Big Dick Randy.
So,
what up?
Phineas got himself taken to Tartarus. That's usually a one-way trip.
Breaking Phineas Wells out of a maximum security penitentiary. I can't think of a better lost cause to commit ourselves to.
To extract the scientist, you will need to infiltrate the labyrinth. But that course of action is likely to be quite dangerous, Captain.
It's a torment, Captain. Think on the deepest, darkest pit you can imagine and wrap it up in a storm so nasty it'll peel the skin right off your bones. That's Tartarus. Still, we can't do nothing. It wouldn't be right.
The elite surveillance protocols on a maximum security prison planet are highly sophisticated. As such, escapes are historically quite impossible and deadly. I am programmed to warn you whenever you exhibit inclinations toward risky behavior. Breaking into Tartarus will not be easy.
Getting in is the simple part. It's getting out again that's the trouble. Trust me, I know.
Let's just do it. Kick down some doors, grab Doc Wells, and cut a path out. We don't need a plan. We got guns.
If you need to do this, you should see to your final affairs and close out any unfinished business. Once you sneak into Tartarus, you may be there a while. Or permanently.
It's the craziest plan I've ever heard. And I mean that as a compliment.
You didn't hire me to think. And I ain't about to start now.
I fucking love it. That was the best line I've ever heard in a video game. That was the best line. Oh my God. Felix has been promoted to the number one goon, or at least in the top 10 goons of video games. My man said, you ain't hire me to think, and I ain't about to start now. What? Sir? Damn, you would be perfect for these corporations. Oh my God, you didn't hire me to think. Why would I start now? Like, what the? Damn, he would make a good soldier. Oh my God. I'm not gonna lie. Red, I know you're watching. I would expect you to say some shit like that to me. Like, let's just say, right? I become anime villain. You're one of my lieutenants. Me, Red, what do you think? You, boss, you ain't hiring me to think. And I ain't about to start now. Where they at? Oh my God, why is that so funny to me? You did not hire me to think, boo-boo. Put your hands up. What? Put thy hands to the air. Oh God. Oh God. Okay, all right, okay. Oh my God, okay, all right. Whew, okay.
Hey, boss, and I'll walk into fire with you.
I think it's insane, but maybe the colony needs a healthy dose of insanity right about now.
I know it's dangerous.
Damn, bro really fucking lie, ignored my party invite and missing me high as shit on mushroom gummies. That's crazy. Boss orgasm me and my ear was not on my bingo.
Damn. Dinkelberg, sorry. I didn't even see I had a party invite from you, Brody. You tend to stay quiet during these streams, so I don't mind being in a party with you. Let me just go to my party. Dinkelberg. I don't see you. I just start the party then. Start party. Closed.
Well, it's me and Loki. King House.
Kame House. Let me see if
then
I see that party.
To PS5. Yeah.
I see Gray Loki party, but it looks like you're the only person in it. You know what? Just send me the invite again. Oh, here we go. It. What? Sure.
No, go on Discord. Join Kane House VC. Transfer to PlayStation.
You're asking for more than bravery from us, Captain.
Jesus, I couldn't get any of that correct. Okay, all right. How do I do that? Like, no one has ever
really
taught me.
I really do like the Outer Worlds. Oh my goodness, how do you not know?
Loki, I'm in a party with you. I can hear you.
He's back. He's in. Or he's not in, but...
So, can someone walk me through how to link that up? Like, how the hell do I do that?
Boss, are you not in the Kame House thing? Because I can't hear you on my end.
I'm in the PlayStation party with you, jackass! Hi.
This is some. Oh.
Yeah. Hi, jackass.
You're in the wrong party, bro. Not that one. I forgot to leave this one. Shit.
Oh. How Hold do on. I do the Discord thing, stupid?
Okay, I should be able to hear you now.
How do I do the Discord thing?
So to go. Okay, I can hear you now. To do the Discord thing, if you have Discord on your phone or any. Thing around you, you go into the party that everyone else is in, then there should be a sign that says connect to console.
Hold on, stop moving so goddamn fast. I'm old, shut up. All right, give me a second.
It's your fault. Ooh. Old man. Actually, I'm holding you, shut up.
No, that's the chill house. No, multiverses. Am I not in the Kame house?
It's manga. In your Haven organization.
Oh, it's in my... I thought it was his own server. Okay, all right, cool. Now I go in here, Kame House, join voices. Cool, I'm in here. Where would this icon be? Oh, PlayStation.
Hi, bud.
Damn, that's loud. First sign in.
Yeah.
He's gonna have a problem.
Yeah, sign into my PlayStation. Sign into my PlayStation.
All right.
Start puzzle.
All right.
I have to start a puzzle. Right. Use the arrow to rotate the
this
object
is...
to face the same direction as the hand.
Gotta
submit.
Close out the party. Hold on.
Submit. Verify. Oh. Okay, so I think I just did it. Did I not just do it? How do you?
Okay, once you've connected your PlayStation account to Discord, when you do.
There we go. And do I still have to be on Discord on my phone? Okay, all right, cool. Nope. Mm-mm. How do I mute him? How do I mute him? How do I mute him?
There are worse ways to go than dying for a good cause. I'm in.
Let Sam get...
Hold on real quick, because I'm finding out what they feel about this suicide mission, and why would you do that? But just hold on.
The grime out. It's what our units do best.
The entire plan is a terrible idea, but I admire your bravado, Captain, which leads me to illogically believe, against the odds, that you will be successful.
I don't. I don't know why...
We gonna prepare? Sure. Guess I could give my ass-kicking boots another coat of polish. You got some sort of plan in mind?
We'll play a smart, talk away through it if we can. I have never had a plan, and I'm not starting now, buddy. Yes, that is the perfect answer to the goon Felix. What? We go in, kill everyone between us.
Now that's a program I can get behind.
Thinking on your feet's more important anyhow.
Yes, who needs a plan?
Something. Oh, how was it like being one of the normals? Hey, can somebody tell me if Outer Worlds 2 has been confirmed? Because if it has, I want it. Oh, yeah, no, I tried to get on, bro, with Deadpool, Tyler, and Gamer, and I just said, absolutely not. You got me fucked up. I don't know who you thought I was, but I'm not him.
Is it time for your daily period of unconsciousness?
But the game is being made. Okay, does anyone know how to lower a town hating you on Outer Worlds? I have one, two. I have two factions that have a kill on sight order for me. Spacer's Choice and the Board. Everybody else likes me. Oh, yeah, no. Oh, no, I didn't fuck up. I killed the town. So here's the thing, right? No. Here's how this worked, right? Here, I'm gonna tell you exactly what happened, right? So I had to pick between the deserters and Spacer's Choice when I redirected the power, right? I chose the deserters. Then, rather than have the woman from the deserters become the leader of that town, I just went to go get the power battery. Now, the mayor told me there's guards down there that will shoot me if I enter in. I'm like, cool. I went down there. I shot through them. But the mayor of the town somehow got into the room. And I guess he thought he was about it because I could have sworn I saw him hit Pravati. So I turned around and started blasting. And then I killed him. Then I walked outside the room, and then all the guards in the town started attacking me. So I killed them. And then Spacer's Choice was just like, yeah, shoot him on sight. But somebody, I was watching a YouTube video, had did the same thing. They triggered the town before they got Vicar Max. So they went and they was like, oh, you just got to sleep for like 120 hours and then they'll stop trying to shoot you. And he went and slept for as long as he needed to, came back and was able to recruit Vicar Max to his team, even though he wiped the town. Like when he walked in, they started shooting him on sight. So that's why I'm like, how do I get rid of the shoot on sight order? Well, that's because you're a bitch and you don't make hard choices. Some people need to die. Nah. See, here's the thing, right? You're okay with them giving themselves into the stagnant conditions of their work. The only way they... Oh, I can do a character respec. Okay, I can't get out of here. Would you like to spend 500 bits to refund all your skills and perk points?
Do you try out our new specification machine?
That would be horrible.
Right before he died.
Oh, I didn't know I could respec. All right. Where do I need to go in the galaxy to finish up some missions? Okay, so... I went against Edgewater, and I chose Botanical. Makes spacesuits won't travel. You know what? Cool. I'm gonna do this. See if this. Do I have the suits that you need? I sold a lot of stuff, lady. Well, here's hoping that Byzantium doesn't shoot me on sight when I land. So it's $60. Shit. I can do what? Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm being shot at and I'm not hearing you right now. I landed in Byzantium. Okay, alright, cool. What were you saying? I can do what with Edgewater? Well, that's not who.
Not hearing anything but you and the game.
So everyone's muted except for me. I don't. What the? Yeah, no, that's on y'all's end. I can't authorize y'all voices to be shared. That's on y'all's end. Let me see something real quick. Yeah, no, I can't authorize any of it. Yeah, that's on you. Don't ask me, Brody.
Clean weapon. Yep. Ain't no call for a closer inspection by anybody.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, that would probably be the best thing to do. Hey, hey, you're doing a lot of talking. Literally, go cram your pie hole. Yeah, I'm the fuck nugget for looking out for you. It's wrong to sell your friends to a circus. It's wrong to sell your friends to a circus. It's wrong to sell your friends to the circus. Isn't that what... My man, I miss it. Since when? Since when? When have I been sold? Why are you selling me?
Lies.
Wait, what? All right. Well, I guess I don't have to worry about you guys talking that very, if only he can hear me in the game. Nah, I don't need to land on Byzantium, but what I do need to do is land somewhere. I can sell stuff. The Groundbreaker should do. Because I actually want to test out some things with the Groundbreaker. If the company, if the board has a shoot on site order for me, are they going to shoot me while I'm on the Groundbreaker? Because if they do, I'm so, so going to enjoy taking them down. You pretentious snobs. Also, am I getting any money when I sell all my junk? Because I'm not seeing it. I guess I'll go to a person and sell everything. I would have went to Byzantium. But they want to shoot me on site. Of course I get a shoot on site for the richest area. Sell everything to Spacer's Choice. They're gonna
have you try.
What are you saying, Martin? That's an anti-Cleo's product.
My law, what have I done? The company will have my head. Both of them. This is awful. Help me, oh Lord!
Gotcha. What I wouldn't give to see the look on your face. This guy's real easy to fuck with.
What kind of depraved mind would conjure such a nightmare?
That's at least a shit, right?
Disagree. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to put this behind us and forget it ever happened.
Let's see.
Have a look.
Okay, I have 2,632. So if I hold to sell all my junk. Okay, yeah, I got a good amount. And how much is up? So 10,000 bits worth of items to a vendor. Cool. All right, I guess there's really nothing else. Why can I not purchase items from a restricted stock? Why did it just... What the...
Perk.
Oh, it's a perk. Got it. Should I be a higher level? Should I do... Okay. You know what? I'm going to decide right now. I'm either going to do Gorgon or I'm going... Oh, wait. No. I want to go see the board thing. I'm either going to go do Gorgon, or I'm going to go do the movie star mission, and I think I might want to do the movie star mission. And if I do that, I'm taking Pravati and, Pravati and Ellie. And then I'll take Nayoka and Felix for the lucky mission.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regularly scheduled advertisement.
I haven't a moment to spare for you just now. Please. Please do return at another time.
What do you think you're doing? I don't want any trouble. What?
Incoming!
What the hell? Shit, did I just lower my reputation with the Groundbreaker? Elevator take me. I guess it was nice to get up here, but there wasn't anything really worth taking up here. This is the largest bathroom I've seen in this game. Oh, no, yeah, y'all had to die. No one's allowed to have a large bathroom like this. Is that a bidet? Oh, no, that's flies. Okay, I thought that was water. I was wrong. Genuinely, that's the largest bathroom I've seen on this game. Every bathroom on this game looks like a closet. Alright. Yeah, the bathrooms are small. Well, maybe not your closet, seeing as you own the internet. You know, your closet's probably the size of a tiny home. I'm going to do something foolish. I'm going to get this science weapon. I'm just going to be very upset about how I have to do this.
We're now in orbit above Fallbrook, Captain.
Remember that you are...
not insured.
All right. The beautiful thing about this is since I've already covered half this area, I can just do this. Let's see here. What's wrong? I'm encumbered? So, oh, right. Right, I've reset my Right. Fuck, I forgot all about that. Okay, this, am I not gonna, requires me to have 5. That boy Dinkelberg said he was going to go make himself something to eat and vanished into infinity and beyond. It was all a dream. Yes, you are. I have to go through all of this. Skill to level 100. Finally! So, should increase the surface tension of the okay. Okay, security checks. Hold on, let me just go ahead and... Cool. Now, let me go ahead and do this. What was this? saw one a minute ago. You're supposed to have a healthy world. Again, arrest your spouse and admit your children to a re-education program. Dang, you gotta arrest. Oh my.
Remember, a human comes out of a human by a human coming into a human. Until we meet again.
Oh, okay, I had to do it again, but that's cool with me. I'm fine with that. Jesus. One, two. Okay, so I know I want this one. This one. Cool. And then I want to get you to 50. I know I had you to 60. Would you rather be, damn it. Would you rather be a Mishima or a Hanma? I'm about to say maybe Lars and Lee. I don't forgive. That is true. Azazel. I mean, is it really horrible? Like, is it really horrible? I'm just saying, you know, sometimes you gotta. First of all, I don't goon. Secondly, I'm going to have to go ahead and do the other missions to make sure I level up again.
I am a dirty autonomous.
Remember me. Though I have this fucking Glock. Hey, quick question. Maybe I haven't played enough Fallout, but do all the Fallout games have companions? Cool. Might want to play Fallout now. Level 30. Character level 30 reached. I just leveled up from coming here? Sweet. I think I fucked myself. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do it like that.
Oh, Captain, it's beautiful up here. Could we get more jobs like this one?
I love Parvati. Oh my gosh, she's such a sweetheart.
Your atmospheric entry wasn't too troublesome. As a guest of honor, you deserve the best in comfort. Sublight Salvage and Shipping Underground, or Slug, as we like to call ourselves, is delighted to welcome you to Eridanos.
Slug.
I'm the Grand Colonial Head, Bellhop. I'm here to grab your bags and direct you, the Inspector, to the Grand Ballroom, which was the scene of the crime. I'll say, there's nary a soul here who wasn't a fan of hers in some respect. Just about everybody's shocked. Some people are
neck.
Inconsolable. Hell, even Black Hole Birdie, Helen's beau, has wandered off. Some folks think he had something to do with the murder, but I don't believe it.
I still don't understand why anyone would have it in for Ms. Helen.
We should ask if they're comping the minibar. This might take a while, if you get me.
Folks get heated when it comes to serials and their actors, I suppose. Not particularly. But I think some folks were jealous of her success, or otherwise viewed her as a threat. Reckon how she came about her fame didn't help.
How did she get famous?
Why, she was a natural. People fell in love with her. She managed to wrangle up a following all on her own. She ended up about as famous and high-runged as your average VP, which rubbed a lot of Byzantines the wrong way. Actors ain't supposed to get preferential treatment.
I imagine the admin briefed you about Helen's part in the Spectrum Brown unveiling. Too bad about the postponement. Not so terrible as Helen's murder, but still a crying shame.
Thought he worked for Slug, not Rizzo's. Was the product release a big deal? Hope they keep it canceled. One less bullshit corporate parade. Guess so, anyway.
Oh, come on! The launch would have been so swell! Rizzo's rented out the ballroom at the Grand Colonial and invited all those guests for just this purpose. Rizzo's ain't unveiled the product since the debut of Spectrum Ultraviolet. Invisible to the naked eye and, as it happened, prone to causing massive internal bleeding. Anyway, I think I've held you up long enough. Once you're ready, head down to the lobby. The ballroom is just behind the elevators. Meanwhile, I'll grab your bags. You're making fun, right? Your luggage, belongings, kit, wherever you keep what you ain't wearing, you're still giving me a pretty blank look. Suppose it's none of my business, but do you just wear the same set of clothes all the time?
Absolutely. No. One of these corpses, honestly.
Well, reckon I can respect your candor, even if it scares me a smidge. Anyhow, I'll look for you in the grand ballroom later. Hope you can unravel this mystery, Inspector.
All right. Fast travel discovered, the luxury landing pad.
Greetings, Inspector. No need to check in here. Your paperwork has all been processed. You should be able to find the Colonial right ahead. No. Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
A lot of doors are sealed in here, people. Maybe you haven't heard, but I, the Commander, do not like locked doors.
This is the hotel? I only ever see in a place like this in periodicals. Or that one episode of Agent Khan.
Helen could meet a fate like this.
It really is a terrible shame. I absolutely adored her cereals.
I almost can't imagine someone wretched enough to do such a thing. You don't think a dissident could be here, do you?
Get a hold of yourself. The administrator would never allow someone as dangerous as a dissident here. Eridanos is safe. This is all just a terrible coincidence.
Of course, of course. You are...
Ooh. Feels like I'm breathing rich people.
Murder has inflicted severe emotional trauma on me. I demand a room upgrade.
I'm sorry, sir, but while the hotel is an active crime scene, I regret to inform you that all new bookings, room upgrades, room downgrades, and in-room massages are suspect. Oh, you're the special inspector. Mr. Kincannon warned me you'd be checking in soon.
Right, yeah.
She's with Dr. Goodnight. Oh, and the victim, of course.
In the Dr. Goodnight.
Oh, the ballroom's right behind the tower elevators. Swing a left or a right, then cut through the crowd of spectators. You can't miss it. The grand... How may I be... My apologies, Inspector, but that would be a severe violation of guest privacy. We here at the Grand Colonial firmly believe that... All right, my supervisor just walked out of earshot. Some folks just don't understand the importance of gossip. About whom? And what would you wish to know?
Oh, sweet. Okay, all right. Talk the dish, bitch. Who is her... Who is Black Hole Birdie?
Ah... Birdie. Is he bigger than he is dumb, or dumber than he is big? I have a bet with a friend. Not sure we'll ever get it to pay out. Birdie used to be Helen's beau, though he isn't anymore, and not just because she's dead. If I had a million bits, I'd spend everyone just to learn what caused their split.
Well.
You know, out of everyone here, I probably knew the least about Helen. I'm not much of an Aetherwave watcher myself. And Helen always had a crowd of admirers chasing her, you see. So she rarely stopped to chat. Friendly enough, surely, but always seemed untouchable. Emphasis on seemed. Now that you mention it, she was usually calm and collected, but every so often I'd see her looking all wild-eyed and intense. It seemed as if she was determined about something. Or maybe she was just hungry? That woman ordered a lot of food. Maybe show business gives you a faster metabolism.
She was pregnant.
If looks could kill, he'd have put her in the ground 10 times over.
Halcyon Helen.
Man's clearly jealous of her success compared to his. See, I'd bet we're the only two people thinking about him in all of Eridanos. And I only am because you mentioned his name. If you leave woolly cow milk out, it turns to curds. Leave the curds out, they begin to get stale, then rot. Woolridge is on his way to the trash bin, and everyone knows it. Either he's in denial, or he knew Helen would be checking out soon, judging by his increasing demands for a room upgrade. That's a shame. Then I guess we'll have to see if you find Helen's murderer, won't we? Myself, and all of the staff at the Grand Colonial, will be rooting for you, Inspector. It certainly is a marvel of modern ingenuity, luxury, and ambition. Please, allow me to answer any curiosities you might have about our building and the amenities on offer.
What if you do? Nothing special about the upper levels. I'm sorry, what disgusting, god-awful, demonic, horrible, whole hellhole shit did you just say out your fucking mouth?
Oh look, a lost Harry Potter character, lol.
Not oh look, a lost Harry Potter character. Someone made a donut and put chitlins in it. They made chitlins in the shape of a donut.
Most certainly. All the important folks can be found in the utmost parts of the hotel. You can hardly walk 3 feet without bumping into a tall.
I don't think I've had chitlins, or if I have, I can't remember. But I think if I did, I don't think they're that bad. I know my wife had chitlins and she likes them.
Twice the size of the next biggest room, and kit it out with any amenity you want, as well as many that you won't. Best to enjoy it while you can, Inspector. Typically, the only people who can afford the penthouse suite have enough bits to suffocate everyone on Terra 2. Also, please inform me if Woolridge gives you a hard time about getting a better room than his. Don't tell him I said this, but everyone on staff wants to strangle him. Who would be interested in a staff-only area? Most folks never ask about the sewers beneath Arizo's plant, either. Of interest to your investigation? Well, I suppose there is that one door we're not supposed to open. But I'm sorry, Inspector, I'm not authorized to grant you access to any staff sections of the hotel. You'll have to find a way in on your own. If you're Of course. Allow me to just pull up your info. It looks like you'll be staying in our luxurious penthouse suite, vacated just recently. So recently that, unfortunately, the room's still being cleaned. I'm sure it'll be ready for you by the time you've examined the crime scene. I believe Constable Keane should be waiting.
So I know at one point I say a tap on screen what my perks were, so I just have to go back to that because I feel like I messed up my own perks.
Oh, come on. Why is the lounge closed?
They can't keep us out.
No, I didn't take a single flaw.
I was going to wash my hands, I swear.
This is the most massive bathroom I have ever seen. I take back what I said before. Sweet, merciful God. This. Look at my stream. Did you say this is a normal size bathroom? You. Oh. Okay. All right. So we see this. We see this, right? Hold on. There's a toilet back here, right? Okay, right. So you see this bathroom, which you call normal size. Hold on. He calls that bathroom normal size, right? Hold on. I took damage just to prove a point. Just to prove a point, I'm taking damage, right? I want you to remember that is that bathroom, right? Here, hold on, is a bathroom. Where is it? There it is. Here's the bathroom on my fucking spaceship. Okay, I want you to understand, my spaceship is pretty big, okay? This isn't a small spaceship. You see this? It's got a whole upper level. No. Shut the fuck up. No. I'm gonna take him to this bathroom, then I'm gonna take him to another planet, and he gonna see that bathroom too, right? So you remember the first bathroom you fucking saw, right? Cool, right? Right? See how big this goddamn spaceship is? Watch this, right? That's the fucking bathroom on my spaceship. Look at this tiny bitch, right? All right. Now, cool, right? You see that, right? Hold on. Well, okay, go ahead. Whoa. That's like a public bathroom to you? Okay, hold on. I said shut the fuck up. Look, come here. I'm gonna take your ass somewhere, all right? We're going to talk about this because you want to be a little asshole about this, right? Hold on. Shut up. We're going to Edgewater. We're going to Rosewater. Shut up. No, stay. Shut your mouth. You cease and desist your actions. Cease and desist. No, you failed the question. Hurry up and win the fight. That was defeatism. I know what I'm about. Where is it? No, hold on. You shut your mouth. You cease and desist your actions. I can get inside one of these houses. Oh, just wait till I can get. Matter of fact, no. Okay, all right. You see this? We are inside a house, basically, right? This is there's the bed, his little workshop area, little mad scientist son of a bitch, right? Check this out. Look how small this fucking bathroom is compared to the other one. Compared to the fucking first one. Yeah. That looks like a public bathroom. All right, you rich fuckhead. Here we are. We're going inside of a bar, right? We're going to go inside a bar. I know they have to have one. This bar doesn't even have a bathroom. If a customer gets pissed drunk, they have to piss outside. No, shut up. This place is horrible. What is this? This is the comms base? This is the Roseway communication room, right? Hold on. Check this out, right? This is a whole office space. Where the fuck? You're not going to tell me that you also don't have a... They don't even have a bathroom. They have one bathroom in this entire fucking town. This is what I have to deal with. It's a hotel settlement. There's no fucking town there. Nah, this is why we eat the rich. Look at this shit. Look at this shit! No, we eat the rich. There's a bedroom. Oh, look! Look! Deadpool. This seems to be more of a... Honestly, I can't tell. The big bathroom? That was a hotel. That was a giant hotel. No bathroom should be that fucking big. For one toilet? For one toilet. For one toilet? One toilet. Tyler, I say this with love in my heart and truth in my soul. You are a part of our friend group. You're an asshole. Whether you want to acknowledge it or not, that's cool. Live your life. But you're a part of our friend group, which means you. So you acknowledge the asshole that you are. I have to search through my own fucking... being a part of this group. Because nobody who's sensitive is going to last long in this fucking group. We all make fun of them way too quickly. You're a cunt. You're an agitator. Tyler, you're precious. You constantly agitate us. We wouldn't pick fights with you if you... You said what? No, not you. I'm talking about Loki agitates. Tyler's precious. Come on. Go over the skills. Just go over the skills. I just need myself to go over the skills real quick.
Red's chaos.
Yeah, red is chaos. No, red is the person I send to just wipe out an area. I'm just like, hey, go wipe out the north. And he would just do it just like, yeah, them, fuck them. Did you just impersonate Uncle Ruckus after asking me how are you the asshole?
Not true.
Because the South has good... Oh, come on. I should have checked my skills after that. Wow. All right, here we fucking go. Okay. So I had this here. Actually, revert. I don't need that. I don't really use that. I'm not responding to that. So I had you. Wow, I had this high. Now I know for a fact that this is here. Yeah, which means if I get the battle pass to get Hades, I'm going to get Korra, so I'm just going to lock her ass away because I don't need to deal with that. Ooh, do you really want the truth? See, they purpose like to piss me off, but real shit. Okay, so you want to know why I hate Korra, right? From the Avatar, right? I'm going to tell you straight up. She's toxic as shit. Okay. All right, so here's my question, right? When Korra was introduced and she met Bo Lin and she had a crush on Mako, what was the first fucking thing she did?
WTF is going on? I'm lost.
Okay, you know what? Red's lost, so I'm gonna drop it. But basically, Tyler asked me, why do I hate Korra? And I'm explaining because she's toxic as hell. What is that?
How did she get brought up?
Korra is part of the battle pass of Fortnite right now. They put Legend of Korra in there. She's the bonus skin. That bad, huh? Thank you. Y'all are making me really want to go look at Poseidon right now. Because I'm like, it can't be that bad.
Whiskey Tango Fox.
Damn, why is everyone on Fortnite tonight? What is going on with the servers? Oh my god. The people who like Korra come off with the same energy as people who like Bakugo. And I'm just like, you know what? I'm tired of arguing with you. I don't fucking know. I'm not talking to you about this shit anymore. You. You mean like torturing and bullying Deku for 10 plus years because quirks manifest at the age of 4, and we saw that Bakugo had recently gotten his quirk when Deku helped him out of that river, or offered to help him out of that river, and Bakugo himself admitted that after that day he started bullying Deku relentlessly, so he was Deku's verbal, emotional, and mental abuser for at least 10 plus years, considering they entered My Hero Academia High School. So if your quirks manifest at 4, and let's just assume that with the Japanese education system, you enter high school at the age of 14, 15, or 16, that is a minimum of 10 years that Deku was being bullied, abused, and tormented by one Katsuki Bakugo. And people want to tell me that he's a good character. Please tell me why you want to fuck your high school bully so badly. That's the only reason I'm saying it. The only reason you like Bakugo is because you want to fuck your high school bully. That's all it is. You want there is no other reason for you to like him. If you're going to choose to look at him as a character and look past the surface, fine. Surface level people that like him, I get it. His powers are cool. His attitude's a little bit different. Fine. You like that. Whatever. But if you're actually deciding to examine the character, you're not going to tell me that you like Bakugo for any other reason than you want your bully to pin you up in the locker room and enter from either hole. Because who likes someone that abuses a person for 10 years? Steadily. That the very first episode we're introduced to Bakugo, he told Midoriya to kill himself. Those were his words. That's what he said to him. His first line in the entire damn show was literally making fun of Midoriya in his dream to be a hero. Midoriya didn't even want to say he wanted to be better than Bakugo. He just wanted to be a hero. And Bakugo, who couldn't even accept anyone else as a hero, remember, he's referred to his own classmates as extras. Anyone that looks at him is just like, oh, well, you know, he's redeemable. He's trying, you know. Oh, he didn't really. It doesn't fucking matter. He wants to be a hero, right? That's his goal. Bakugo wants to be a hero. I don't know any hero that tells a person that just wants to help to go kill themselves when they're not being destructive about the way they want to help. He didn't tell him you're better off being a cop or a firefighter or hell, even a crossing guard. He told him to end his life. That's not a fucking hero. Even the own society of heroes recognizes he doesn't act like a hero. The villains thought that he didn't act like a hero. People have his classmates, the school. No one thinks that this fuckhead acts like a hero. And just because he makes a fucking apology and that he fucking what? I don't know, risked his life to save Deku? Oh, congratulations. I'm sorry. You risking your life to save Deku as an apology is not as good as Deku in the first fucking episode risking his non-powered life to save yours after you beat him for years. And you can't even thank him properly for it. All you've ever done is just ridicule him, bully him, and tell people that they're extras and that they don't deserve to be on the same stage as you. You are the worst fucking character to ever grace the screen. You are a piece of shit, and the only reason people like you is because they want to, once again, fuck their bullies. Because that's all you are. You're just a bully. You're just a manipulator. You're just an abuser. You're nothing else. You haven't started your Redeemer. You're more Endeavor than Endeavor. Oh, God. Ooh. Yes. Wow. Tyler, wow, I'm glad I didn't open my mouth. Yeah. Oh, man. I'm sorry, I just genuinely, I genuinely hate Bakugo. No. I avoided talking about that. I avoided talking about that specific trope because last time I talked about that trope, those fucking let me explain something, right? Let me say this right now. No, shut up. This is to the stream. Stream, I want you to know this right now. I want you to know I'm not a Republican. Okay, I am a liberal person, okay? I am a very equal person. The words that were about to come out of my mouth before I caught them, because I heard them in my head, wow, they were Republican. Because I was about to insult the hell out these people. Let me just say it right now. This is it. This is all I'm saying on the matter, right? If you want to ship Bakugo with Deku, at this point, I'm just going to let you know, fine, do it. Stop trying to make everyone else see it and stop having a negative reaction when people tell you this is fucking triggering. Because I can guarantee you right now, if I call you the wrong fucking pronoun, you're going to say something about it. So if I'm telling you, hey, seeing a person that abused somebody for 10 years being romanticized, not a good thing. Listen. And if you don't choose to listen, I hope you walk into a bug zapper, just your forehead, and it just knocks you back. Doesn't kill you, but I want a burn mark on your forehead. I hope you get Todoroki'd by a bug zapper. That was the most tamest thing I could think to say. Hey, Red. You really don't want me to actually. Okay, everyone's telling me Poseidon looks bad. All right. Thank you guys for your patience. I'm so sorry about all that. I went on a tangent. I redid my stats properly to the way I had them before. I thank everyone for their patience. Truly, let's just go on with the mission that we're doing on Eridanus. Whew.
Touchdown on the atmospheric complex in Eridanus.
You know what? You know what? Let's talk about a character I don't like, but everyone, like, there's, like, I've heard mixed reviews about this character, and I don't like them for any toxic reason. I just don't like the character in general. How do y'all feel about Cam, the Green Samurai Ranger? I'm gonna be honest with you, Cam just wasn't likable as a character to me.
I love him.
Oh, I understand. Dre says he loves him. I couldn't get into him, dude. Like, I was watching his story and I was just like, I get that, you know, your dad's being overprotective, but you're really coming off as an arrogant asshole right now. And even when he got the Power Ranger thing, I'm like, cool, you're kind of learning to work as a team member, but you're still just an arrogant asshole right now. Like,
Cassie and Helen's death was the worst part of all this.
Yeah, I get it.
I did not read about this kind of... Black hole birdies disappeared, you know.
Alright, time to look at this.
Oh, thank the law. Inspector, you don't know how relieved I am to see you. Constable Maria Keene. It's good to meet you in person, Inspector.
Dr. Goodnight. Ecstatic to make your various acquaintances and so on. Are we finished with the pleasantries? There's something I'm excited to show you. An extraordinary contraption. You'll love it.
Our coroner has developed a device which may prove useful in your investigation. Our office has instructed her to hand it over to you.
Our office has instructed her to hand it over to you. Oh, please. You make it sound as if I'm turning over stolen goods. Behold, my discrepancy amplifier. Hold it in your hands. Feel the way it hums with ontological potential. I work with the materials to which I have access. Halcyon has no shortage of rifles. The discrepancy amplifier uses a deterministic model of our universe to detect the discrepancy between what should be and what actually is. Then it renders any discrepancies visible by using the power of magnification.
I liked Ziggy. He was funny. Yeah, he was funny.
Oh, goodness, no. I don't care for OSI doctrine. I just enjoy their math.
I'm contractually prohibited from endorsing off-brand technology, but I'll bend that rule just this once.
So outside of Tommy, obviously, you know, respectful reasons, of course. Who is everyone's personal favorite green Power Ranger? And I don't mean the Sixth Ranger. I mean anyone who's ever rocked the color green outside of Tommy, for respectful reasons, of course. Yeah. Isn't Draken just the Green Ranger? Isn't Draken just Tommy from another dimension? And I did say outside of Tommy and JDF. So technically, because he is a Tommy, I didn't say I understand he goes by Draken, but he's still a Tommy. I'm going to go with the Green Ranger from Mystic Force. That or the Elephant Ranger.
Take a look at the crime scene.
Go on, Inspector.
Correct. When did Rita Repulsa become... All right, fine. Well, then watch Power Rangers, damn it. It's on Netflix, Hulu, it's literally everywhere. All right, then be as stubborn and difficult as Red is with Lazelle.
I'd be more
Black Red Turbo Ranger. Oh, the Black Red, Red, please, for the love of God, don't say black like that, because I'm thinking you mean like their color scheme was black and red. I just realized you mean the Red Ranger who was black. Oh. Yeah, TJ. Yeah, but Turbo that's revolved around, yeah, Turbo revolves around cars, and if you're just going around cars, then it's either RPM or Turbo. So, you're talking about the little kid that turned into an adult? I backed that up. I'm going to go ahead and say right now, I'm going to agree with Red that he's amongst the best Blue Rangers. I don't think he's my number one Blue Ranger, but I see him in my top five. Yeah, the little kid that turns... Yeah, the little kid that turns into a Blue Ranger. Yeah, he was cool as shit to me when I was a kid. Give me the short version. Sure, what you have.
Our leading lady must have riled up someone. Her wounds, from cranium to metatarsal, are as follows. A blow to the head, severe enough to lacerate the flesh. Followed by a suite of plasma burns down the neck and back, signs of poisoning, evidence of...
One of my favorite Blue Rangers, besides Billy, just besides the OG cast, or at least for us, outside of Mighty Morphin, Sky.
Inanition and desiccation, possible signs of jaundice, some shingles, one malformed toenail.
Okay, look, you can argue with me up and down that you can argue with me up and down that Sky is a specious. I will 100% accept that argument. There has been nothing that really shows that he's a racist. Yes, I get what he said to the black, I get what he said to the Red Ranger. I do. I'm not excusing what he said. Hold on, no. I'm not excusing that. What I am saying is this. No. Because if I'm right, we're referring to when he was basically speaking down to him, telling him he was unworthy of the position and he was a criminal, right? Right. He was literally locked up when he was recruited. So, by Sky's standpoint, just looking at the dude's chart, seeing where he was recruited from, yeah, he's a criminal. And Sky, who's been by the book his entire life, working for this and knowing his father used to be a Red Ranger, yeah, I can understand why the hell he said what he said. I'm not saying it was right. I'm not saying he was correct for doing it. I'm just saying, given those things, I don't think it was coming from a point of racism. I think it was simply coming from a point of how dare someone who was locked in prison and never trained for this a day in their life beat me. How fucking dare you?
That's good advice. I'll just strike out malformed toenail as a possible cause of death. The short version is this. Mm-hmm. Helen was killed by poison, a blow to the head, and a plasma wound. Possibly more.
The Psycho Rangers. All of you are wrong.
I am, of course, at your service.
Psycho Rangers. The Psycho Rangers, dog. And if you read the Power Rangers comic book...
Oh, good. One of my favorite subjects. Ask away, my dear. Ask away.
Oh, God. You're talking about the white pterodactyl ranger? Okay, yeah, no. Look, he had a clean suit. He was a strong fighter. Bro, I'm telling you right now, the fact that they made that man evil, then good, then back to evil, then good, only to, like, the whole entire back and forth he was doing, dog, that turned me off of his character so quickly. I was like, bro, you cannot keep doing the same shit, like, repeatedly. It's not Trent, dude. It's not Trent. It's not. I'm just gonna. Loki, this is one of your bad choices again.
I didn't expect an existentialist question so early today.
You think it's a good opinion.
A need. Just as sprats feel they must breed, or canids feel they must brutally maul each other.
No. I'ma immediately shut all that down. I'm sorry. You may be the Dinkelberg. No, Dinkelberg would definitely not back you up on Trent. If you're going with evil rangers, then the rangers from fucking Ninja Storm were better than Trent. The evil rangers, the evil brothers from Ninja Storm? Every villain is the good guy in their own fucking story. Mezagon thought he was the good guy doing what he was doing.
You're smarter than I look. Guess there's no shame in telling you exactly what it is you're using, seeing how you're so curious. As it so happens,
motherfucker, I watched the show. I know what they thought. I'm telling you, every villain has thought that they're doing the right thing, except for Rita Repulsa and Lord Zedd. They just straight up said, no, we're evil. That there is no other reason. We're doing this because we're fucking evil. Like, the villains from that era, and maybe Divatox. Evil. Right? Cool. Evil. After that, all the villains were just basically not evil. They were just doing what they thought was better. Lotor from Power Rangers, what is it? The time-traveling one? He was literally the victim of discrimination. He was doing what he was doing to give his people a fighting chance. That's not evil. RPM was just a machine. There was no fucking emotion behind it. There was no good or evil. It was just a calculation. That's like telling me that addition is inherently evil. A computer program is not inherently evil. And by that same regard, the Power Rangers that had the Machine Emperor, not inherently evil. A machine with a task and executing it. There actually haven't been that many evil people. Even one of my favorites, Power Rangers Jungle Fury, Daishi, not actually inherently evil. The person who Daishi was possessing was doing evil actions. He was possessed and just trying to get stronger. He genuinely did not care about conquering the world. He didn't care about sowing destruction. His objective, get stronger, beat the Power Rangers. That's it. Daishi, on the other hand, malevolent spirit. And then you're just arguing with the concept of malevolency. So I guess you can go ahead and put Daishi somewhere in the evil range, but it's not like he chose evil. He is literally made of it.
Technically, it wasn't his whole brain.
If we're talking about the evil Rangers, Trent's okay, but he's not the best.
Rot in a closet somewhere. Besides, my husband was the prior constable. He would have wanted his brain used for the pursuit of justice.
No. You asked who's this. Okay, all right, fine. We're talking about, hold on. We're talking about the best inspector. Singular evil Power Ranger than the Green Psycho Ranger who fought the 1970s Power Ranger. Because amongst the list of evil Power Rangers, he's the only one to have successfully killed two Power Rangers. And he was the only one that's technically been a Power Ranger and a Psycho Ranger all at the same time.
I realized I had my own part to play. I programmed the amplifier.
He had a monster transformation and a Megazord.
To your care, because I want to see my invention help a brilliant inspector solve the murder of the century. You don't miss a thing, do you, Inspector? I can see why the constable recommended hiring you. Think of the amplifier as my gift to you. May it avail you in the swift and efficient prosecution of...
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I haven't seen that one yet.
I still have the blueprint and several extra prototypes floating around, but I might recommend you try to be careful with it. Some of the amplifier's internal components are rare, shall we say, and I don't have an in-depth...
All right, I'm sorry, stream. I'm getting back to the game.
Inspector. I've worked at the Grand Colonial for about as long as it's been around. Prior to that, and that something turned out to be corpses. Byzantium has much in the way of luxury, but examining the dead does not
also,
rank amongst the
I'm sorry,
activities
right now,
of the elite.
The Psycho Rangers are also the best villains in Power Rangers because amongst the Psycho Rangers, including the Green Psycho Rangers, the Psycho Rangers have killed a total of three Power Rangers. Pink killed Pink, and if I'm correct, Green Psycho killed the Red Ranger. And the Pink Ranger. Yeah, so they both killed the Pink Ranger. And Pink almost killed two Pink Rangers.
It's not necessarily that I dislike it. Just that I think the day in, day out,
the second best evil Power Ranger villains who technically weren't evil, the Spirit Rangers.
Sometimes you need to get a little corpse blood on your hands to remember why life's worth living. Absolutely. Usually I'm just a medical practitioner, so I almost never get to deal with anything as unique or as quiet as a corpse. The most interesting thing I saw, if I weren't here, I'd be back in my quarters, rewatching.
Okay, where did you put this picture? Discord?
Working on my automatic sprat peeler.
Okay, let me look at this. Oh, is it bad that I... Hold on. I like the Green Ranger Shredder design, but I like that as a better design for Draken than I do for Shredder.
Oh, good. One of my favorites.
Well, it's Shredder with the Green Ranger power, so... Also, I have...
Captain, please show a little respect.
Yeah, I noticed them with the turtle armors. Yeah, no, it's DC Comics.
The discrepancy amplifier is now operational. Greetings, designated inspector and/or unauthorized larcenist. This unit has detected a discrepancy related to Halcyon Helen.
Yeah, but doesn't that mean that the Power Rangers won't show up in the Marvel Universe?
Amplification? The discrepancy amplifier has been programmed with advanced speech recognition, scientific analysis, and deterministic calculus protocols.
You know, the saddest thing...
Oh, you'll love this. Amplifier, tell the inspector.
You know what the saddest thing about the Power Rangers is?
Please do not interrupt the discrepancy amplifier.
You can create the Power Rangers
registered or designated
by literally just asking two superheroes to work together, and they belong to the same club as well.
An automated personality simulator.
You can create the Power Rangers in Marvel by just simply asking Iron Man and Doctor Strange to work together, and they're both part of the Illuminati. Doctor Strange to provide the magic source, Iron Man to provide the tech.
This footprint stands out from the normally.
Doctor Strange has been able to survive. Doctor Strange is definitely has the ability to create a dimension. And considering how he has specifically stated that he has been able to either fight a god or like literally become one, I don't put I do not put being able to create a singular universe whose sole purpose is to house a massive energy source that other beings draw from above him. I mean, literally, that's kind of what Mephisto did with the whole entire Ghost Rider thing. So it's literally possible for them to do it.
The dirt carries traces of fertilizer, as well as the faint signs of crushed purple berries and grass. Grass, fertilizer, and purple berries can all be found in the purple berry or- This deduction-
Good work, Inspector. You'll need- Check in-
I knew I should have gotten her autograph when I had the chance.
Why is everybody staring? Didn't nobody teach him to respect the dead? Oh gosh, is that Miss Helen? Can we see?
Does being on the case give us temporary immunity? Think they'll let us confiscate a few stray bits? Something on your mind?
I can't believe I used to. Breathtaking. Have you looked over the edge of the complex yet? Just watch the clouds turning? It's like an ocean without end. Eridanos and Olympus are the two biggest planets in Halcyon. King and queen of the sky. Looking out to the horizon, I get this feeling that we're in the company of royalty. Eridanos is 100 times the mass of Terra 2, 800 times the volume. 10 times the diameter. We're flying through the tiniest layer of habitable atmosphere. Sometimes I can't believe how small my world used to be. My horizons were about as wide as the walls of Edgewater. I'm glad you landed in the Vale, even if you did land right on top of Captain Hawthorne. You know what? I'm spoiling the moment. Let's get back to it. Yeah? You want to ask about anything in particular, Captain? What's on your mind?
I gotta stop hitting square.
The Grand Colonial Front Desk warmly welcomes you, Inspector. It's a pleasure to see you again. How may I be of assistance to you, Inspector? Ah, yes. We are most pleased to offer you our grandest of grand accommodations, Inspector. The penthouse suite on our topmost floor is now available for you. The last guest left her belongings behind when she vacated unexpectedly, so we needed a little time to tidy the suite up for you. Simply call the elevator in the lobby, and our highly skilled operator will deliver you to your private floor with efficiency and cheer.
Okay.
Hello there, my inordinately esteemed guest. If my hello were any more earnest,
Angel does?
This loudspeaker would explode. What authorized
floor and he's gay.
Can I bring you to?
Well, to be fair, he could have been bi or pan. No. It was dating.
There is such a thing as too clean. We ought to break open a few bottles
and have
some
fun. There's no room service, right?
We're telling you that originally, Inspector, before she went and said what she said about the cherry bomb thing, like you're saying, you're right. But before she said that, the design work that she had put Angel and Vaggy in a relationship. Like, there were very suggestive poses with them, ones that could not be explained away with friendship. It was clearly signs of caring, endearing, attraction, and then she just made him gay. I don't know why she decided to do that, but hey, she made him and Vaggy both gay. Charlie, if I'm right, Charlie's bi, Vaggy's a lesbian, Angel's gay, Husker's pan, Alistair's ace, Nifty straight, and I don't know what the hell Serpentius was.
You know, for crime.
I don't know what Serpentius was.
She will be
sore. Or his egg boys. Oh, Serpentius was.
I will be plain with you. I prefer not having to hire you at all. This matter should be resolved by Rizzo's security, but Cedric owns the land complexes, so we have a jurisdiction problem. Constable Keene encouraged us to hire a third-party freelancer. Right now, you're the best chance we have at resolving this incident and getting on with our affairs.
Relax, I've been solving the problem for two idiots, you know.
I see. Well, I appreciate your candor. Yes, let's go with that. Back to the matter at hand. Tell me about your investigation. Your discretion is appreciated. I admit, I'm beginning to feel more confident in this arrangement. Here, I'm granting you access through the gates to the orchards. You're officially authorized to see this investigation through to the end. There is one caveat. Cedric's being rather intransigent about letting you into the spaceport. Possibly he's trying to hide something. Possibly he wants to annoy me. Possibly both.
I think I've actually decided to take time to design OCs. When people make OCs and they design original characters, when people make OCs and they design these characters, right? Question. Do they usually write for them as well? Like, maybe a backstory or a history.
I agree with the sentiment behind your snide remark. Unfortunately, the Piraeus spaceport is Cedric's purview, not mine.
Okay.
You have a lead to chase. Law speed, Inspector.
Okay. All right, I'm going to be honest with you, stream. I have not been responsible tonight to y'all as a streamer. I got stuck in this conversation, and that is my problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call the stream here because it has been a while since I've talked to these guys. I've just been stuck in this game. We're going to pick this back up. I'm glad that you guys couldn't hear them so you could hear the game. I just apologize for the long breaks and time pauses I had in between. So I'm just going to call it right here for the night. And I'm going to get on Fortnite so I can see what the hell they've been talking about. So, yep. Thank you for coming to the stream tonight. I love you guys. See you tomorrow.